Hello students, I am Dr. Achit Shivastav, Associate Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, SKIT Jaipur. So today we are going to learn how to plot OC curve in Excel. The OC curve is drawn between the probability of accepting a shipment to the person defective, and this is the type 1 error, that is the producer error or the manufacturer error. This is noted by alpha 0.5. So the type 1 error or the manufacturer risk is nothing but it is the rejecting the good product or the good lot, because sometimes in sampling there can be the chances that there can be the good lot gets rejected. So that is a type 1 error. And suppose the bad lot gets accepted and it will come to reaches to the consumer, so this is the consumer risk. So that is noted by beta. So this is generally taken as nearly 10%. This is generally taken as the 0.5, or the 5% is the manufacturer risk. This is the 10% is the consumer risk, and this is the curve which is shows the area within the curve shows the lots that gets accepted. Now this is the where the 0.5%, you can see this is the line which shows the up to this and beyond. We can make a vertical line here, so up to two, so this is the good quality up to this. So this is the good quality and this is denotes the acceptable quality limit AQL. And if we see the consumer risk where the beta, so this 0.1, so this intersects the OC curve at this point. So this is the anything beyond this is worst quality level or the rejected quality level, so RQL, and the quality which is in between the units that are needed to be accepted in between the AQL and RQL. So this is the reason of, you can say, indecision whether to accept it or not accept it. So this is the probability of accepting the shipment. So probability of acceptance has been shown on y-axis, and the percent defectives, 1%, 2%, 3%, up to 6%. This is the percent defectives have been shown on the x-axis. And this is, we already seen, this is the manufacturer or the producer risk, that is noted by alpha. This is the consumer risk, it is noted, we can say it is noted by beta, and it is also known as type 2 error, means the accepting the bad lot. Now, how to plot this OC curve? So, for plotting the OC curve, there is an experiment has been conducted in the quality control lab. So, to see the what are the details of the experiment, so let's have a look on the whatever the how the experiment has been conducted in the quality control lab. In the quality control lab, we have conducted the experiment by taking a box containing 100 balls, out of which 82 are white balls that represents the good product, 18 colored balls, out of which one is the blue ball, 2 are the red balls, 5 green balls and 10 yellow balls are considered as defective. An experiment is performed by drawing the 10 balls randomly with replacement to determine the defectives. And this experiment for drawing the 10 balls at one time has been done 20 times. So the number of trials for this experiment is 20, and we have picked 10 balls at a time, and we are just interested in finding how many defects are there. So that observation table of the whatever the observation that has been obtained in this experiment is documented in this table. And what the what we needed to do, so we have been needed to do the, we have to plot the OC curve for the single sampling plan and for the acceptance number 0, 1 and 2. The acceptance number is the how many number of the items that are needed to accept the sample, because it is very difficult to do the sampling of each and every part in the lot. So what we do, 100% inspection is never possible, so we go for the sampling. And for the sampling, again, it can be done by single sampling plant or double sampling plant, but here we are choosing the, what we can say, the single sampling plant, and the acceptance number is taken as 0, 1 and 2. Now, to plot the OC curve, as we have already done the experiment, this of drawing the 10 balls at one time, and this has been repeated 20 times. So now we are interested in finding the number of defects that we have obtained. So number of defects is represented by the colored balls. So first we need to know the number of the defects in each instance. Suppose in the first time we have conducted, taking 10 balls at a time, and how many number of the colored balls we have obtained, of green color and red, blue, yellow, so that we are going to find. So for doing this, just make a table and we just count the, use the count function, so that we can able to count the specific balls. How it has to be done? So we are interested in finding the blue balls, which are 1% of the total balls. So because we have taken the 100 balls, and the blue is 1, and red is 2, green is 5, and yellow is 10 in this particular box from where we have drawn 10 balls at one time. So for the first sample, let's see. So we can make use of the, again, the, we can make use of the function COUNTIF. Now I have to select the whatever the range from where I have to count the number of the colored balls. Now first I am going to count the blue balls. So I just, red, blue, so there is 0 blue balls in the first experiment. I can drag it down like this. So I drag it down like this. So this will show the, there is only one instance, that is the experiment number 9. There is one blue ball like here. So it has been showing here. Now for finding the red balls, again I have to write this command count if selected. It has been selected. Then I will just write red, because I am interested in determining the red balls. So close the bracket. Now here there is 0 red balls in the first instance, second, 10, up to 20. Let's see what is the number of the red balls are there. So it is coming here 1 and in this there is 1. So, and here also in the experiment number 16, the 16th time I have repeated the experiment, so there I have got the red balls. Okay, now for checking, the same count has to be done by the, for the green balls. Again write the same command, count is, again we have to select the range like this, comma, then we write green. Now just drag this formula down Now, for all the number of sample 1, sample 2, sample 3 means the trial 1, trial 2 up to 20, we can see the green balls occur. So in the first instance occur here 2 times, so like this, I have the value. Now for the yellow, again I write the same formula, COUNTIF. I have to select the range, then comma, then I have to write yellow, now to check, I am just drag it down and I have seen these are the number of yellow balls. Now, so this has been done for the blue ball, red ball, green, yellow, everything has been. Now we have obtained the how many blue balls in the first instance, red balls, green, so 2 green and 2 yellows. Now I am interested in finding the counts. How many? Because we want to determine the probability. For determining, for drawing the OC curve, we need the probability from the experiment. What the experiment probability is coming. How many instances in which, because this experiment is repeated 20 times, how many instances in which we are getting zero defects. So how we are going to do it? But for, in order to do it, we have to do the count. So again, I have to make use of the COUNTIF function to determine the instances up to which we have determined the zero. So COUNTIF, again, we have to select from here. Now I am interested in finding the how many instances we have obtained zero defect. Oh, it's 19, because 19 we have got the zero defect. Now the same thing I can repeat it for the this. I can just drag it down the formula. So now you can see here the I have just drag, take the formula at this side. So what happens, this is for the red balls, 15 instances, only 5. There 15 instances having 0, there is the only 7 instances, because there is already values are there. So likewise, we have computed the instances up to which there has been 0 defects for the yellow balls, green balls and blue balls. Now I am interested in finding the how many instances that we have obtained the one defect. So again, making use of the count function, COUNTIF function, select the range here, comma, then I will simply write one. So you can see this is only one instance. Now let's check for the red ball. Red ball, it is showing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 instances. Okay. For the green ball. So green ball, only 1 and 1, only 2 instances. Okay. And for the yellow ball, so it is coming 8 instances. Because this probability is large, so there was more instances will be there. So now for finding the having the 2 defects. Okay, so let's check it again. I am using the same formula. Select the range, comma, then get the color for the color yellow. Well, sorry, we have to see how many instances in which we have obtained two defects, only two defects. So this is 0. Here again 0. Here 3 instances where we have getting the exactly 3 defects. Okay, first this, and I can further take this here. So there are the 4 instances having the defects. Now I have obtained this values. This selecting this table which we have obtained this table. Now for plotting the OC curve, I go to the insert charts, all charts, scatter, and this is the one I have picked. So this shows the OC curve where I can write as. So before writing, I can just format the axis. So this is the percentage defective we have taken up to 10%, which shows the yellow balls. So this is 10. This cannot be more than 1. Probability of acceptance is taken here, so I have to mention it as 1. So now this is our chart, control chart. This is the Now I can write here, this is the OC curve. I can add the whatever the axis titles. So axis titles can be added like this. So this side, this is represents the probability of acceptance. Bracket A. This represents the percentage defective. Percent defective. Percent, 2%, 4%. So now I can also change the I can increase the font. So this is the acceptance number, C equal to 0. You can see here C equal to 1, C equal to 2. C equal to 0 is more tightened. Less number of the products will get accepted. C equal to 1, the more area is there, the more number of the products will get accepted. C equal to 2 is further, there can be the more number of the acceptance rates increases. So likewise, we can draw the OC curve for the data that we have obtained here. Now after plotting the OC curve with the whatever the data that has given obtained from the experiment, now for drawing the theoretical OC curve. So theoretical OC curve can also be drawn, because we know, suppose I am drawing for the acceptance number 2, C equal to 2, here n is the whatever the number of the experiments we have conducted, so 20, n equal to 20, fraction defective, suppose I also take 0, 1%, 2%, 5%, 10% as we have done in the experiment, one for the blue balls, so that signifies 2%, and here's the 5 balls, that's 5%, 10%. Probability, so we know the probability P is 0.0, here 1%, 0.01, 0.02, 0.05, 0.1. Now the mean of the, because it follows the theoretical OC curve, it follows the Poisson distribution. This is the Poisson distribution formula. Lambda is the mean, lambda to the power x, x is the whatever the events that are taking place, e minus lambda x factorial. So x is the what is the number of the events. So here suppose the acceptance number 2, so x can be the whatever the number of defects, maximum can be the 2, so the x value will be the 2. And since in the for finding the probabilities in the for the, when the acceptance number is 2, so we have to take the summation of this, so up to k, x equal to 2. So first from 0 e minus lambda, so lambda is np, that is the mean. So what is the mean in the Poisson distribution is np, so n, so this mean is the same as in the binomial distribution, but only the difference is the number of instances or the trials are very very high in the Poisson distribution, and the probability is quite less as compared to the binomial distribution. So this is the mean, lambda denoted by np, so I can write for plotting it. So this is here n is the 20, so I can just put the dollar sign here so that it will not change again and again, and multiply it by the what is the this part. So this gives the mean value. Now just so I have got this, I drag it down, so I have written the determine the what is the mean value for 0 here, this. Now for finding the probability of acceptance, so we have to make use of a function, Poisson distribution. So Poisson dist, this is the function that has to be used. Now for the x value, so x is the whatever the number of the instances, we can see here acceptance number for 2. Suppose I am making it for 2, so I just select this. Okay, since I have taken the reference, again I put the dollar mark so that it will not change. Then mean we have just computed here, this is the mean value. Then the cumulative, yes, we wanted the cumulative, so true. And select it. This is the probability. Obviously, 0% there will be probability, 0 defects, there will be 1 is the 100% probability. So these are the probability values we have obtained. Further. Now, with this, we can plot the OC curve. So how to plot the OC curve? Again, I will select this probability percent. This is the fraction defect. I select it, and this is the probability of acceptance. So I go to the data, sorry, insert, then the chart. This is the plot. You can see this is the OC curve that has that can be drawn like this. So we have obtained this. Then I can add axis titles, the title of it. This is OC curve. You can write OC curve. Here I can add probability of acceptance PA. This is percent defectives. And I can format this. This the names has been written. So I just select format axis. Here we have taken up to 10% defectives. And here the probability cannot be more than 1. So selected 1. So in this way we have drawn the theoretical OC curve, and here I can also change the font size if I want to change. So this is the theoretical OC curve that has been drawn again between the probability of acceptance and the percent defectives. This is for C equal to 2. Suppose I want to change the acceptance number 1. Here I have typed C equal to 1. So you can see there is the lesser number of the parts or the samples that will be accepted. If I further reduce the acceptance number C equal to 0. So now you can see this is the change in the OC curve. So in this way we have seen in this lecture how to draw the OC curve, first on the basis of the experimental data and later on on the basis of the whatever the theoretical data. So this is a theoretical OC curve, and we have seen the OC curve based on the experimental data. So thank you for listening, and I can format this. The names has been written. So I just select format axis. Here we have taken up to 10% defectives, and here the probability cannot be more than 1. So selected 1. So in this way we have drawn the theoretical OC curve, and here I can also change the font size if I want to change. So this is the theoretical OC curve that has been drawn again between the probability of acceptance and the percent defectives. This is for C equal to 2. Suppose I want to change the acceptance number 1. Here I have typed C equal to 1. So you can see there is the lesser number of the parts or the samples that will be accepted. If I further reduce the acceptance number C equal to 0. So now you can see this is the change in the OC curve. So in this way we have seen in this lecture how to draw the OC curve, first on the basis of the experimental data and later on on the basis of the whatever the theoretical data. So this is a theoretical OC curve, and we have seen the OC curve based on the experimental data. So thank you for listening.